Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today in this video we will see the laser based measuring devices VH80, Bagel, P1S and Bosch. We will also understand the working principle of laser based measuring devices. Many times we need to take the measurements at difficult places, or sometimes we need to move people for the measurement. So that we have VH80 device which works on a laser based technology. With the help of this device, difficult measurements can be taken easily. It has both side measuring facility so that we can measure from both side or with one side. With a single button press, we can measure the left and right side distance. Because of these above feature, it is very time saving equipment. It has a sketch application in which we can save the picture and measurements. With the help of these, we can easily do the space management. It has a feature of calculating the midpoint, which can be used for the different application. It has another feature of calculating the height with the help of the Pythagoras. It can also calculate the area and volume. Next device is Bagel. We can measure any complicated shape with the help of this device. It has three modes, which are string mode, wheel mode and remote mode. By string mode, we can measure length and diameter. Wheel mode is used for measuring irregular shapes, and in complicated area, we can take measurements with the single hand. Remote mode is used to measure the distance which is far away. After taking the measurements, there is no need to note it down because it has a feature of attaching the voice recording to a related measurements, and the measurement is sent to the mobile application with the help of the Bluetooth. It is a very precise instrument. It has a good screen quality and it is compact in size. Now the next device is P1S. It is very lightweight and portable device. It is manufactured for the home applications. It has variety of use. It has only two buttons by which we can measure the area and volume. Hence, it is very automated device for the measurement. We just have to strike the laser on the object to take down the readings, and with this we can easily do the space management. It has a good performance and stability. It has OLED screen which gives the better display quality. It has inbuilt level sensor and rotating screen. It has a special attachment. With the help of that, we can measure the height. It has the timing mode so that a single person can take all the measurements. P1S is very compact and perfect device. Now the next device is Bosch GLM40. It is also compact and well designed product. It has a facility of continuous measurement. It can automatically calculate the area and volume. It can also store up to 10 readings. As this all described devices has their own working principle, now we will see the working principle of VH80. Before that, we will understand the components first. The first component is laser source. The laser is developed inside the source, then focused and striked on the object. The laser will travel at the speed of the light, which is 300,000 km per second. The second one is avalanche photodiode. These are the devices, when exposed in the light or radiation, it will produce voltage according to their intensity of the light. There are different types of photodiodes, but the avalanche photodiode has a high capacity of producing the current as compared to the others. The third one is amplifier. It receives the signal and it increases the amplitude of the given signal. The next one is microcontroller. These are like small computers. They are already used in the variety of electronic gadgets. We can also save the programs in the microcontrollers. These devices are similar to the computers, but they have very less memory and RAM. Another one is, that is the last part of the device, is LCD screen. They are used to display the results. Now we will understand the principle. First of all, the laser developed in the source and striked on the object. At the same time, the microcontroller starts the timer. When the laser receives, it is focused on the photodiode. Photodiode develops the voltage according to the intensity of light. It is transferred to the amplifier. Then amplifier increases the amplitude of the given signal and transmit it to the microcontroller. As the signal received to the microcontroller, it stops the counter. In the program of microcontroller, the formula of distance calculation is stored. The formula is distance is equal to counted time into speed of the light divided by 2 into clock frequency. The distance is shared with the screen which is attached to the microcontroller and which displayed in the required unit format. As now we can understand the working principle, you can comment down if you want any related gadget information. Thanks for watching the video. Please do like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thank you.